Welcome to an example on how to graph the standard equation of a parabola when the vertex is not at the origin and the parabola opens left or right. So the first thing we should recognize is that the given equation fits this form of the standard equation of a parabola, where the y part is squared and the x part is to the first power, which is the reason why the parabola opens to the left or right. For example, if the equation fit this form, where the x part was squared and the y part was to the first power, we'd have a vertical axis, meaning the parabola would open up or down. But again, in our case, our equation fits this form where the y part is squared, the x part is to the first, so we'll have a horizontal axis, meaning the parabola will open to the right or left based upon the sine of a. So now going back to our example, the vertex of the parabola will have coordinates hk, and since we have the quantity x plus 1, the x coordinate is negative 1, and because we have the quantity y minus 2, the y coordinate is positive 2. Next, the parabola will open to the right if a is positive, and open to the left if a is negative. So again, looking at the form of our equation, we should recognize that 4a is equal to 8, so if 4a equals 8, and we divide both sides by 4, we can see that a is equal to positive 2. So because a is positive, the parabola will open to the right as pictured here. Notice how it opens around the positive x-axis. And now to help us find the other components of the parabola, we're going to plot the vertex and make a rough sketch of a parabola that opens to the right. And then after we find all these key components, we'll finish by making a more accurate graph. So the vertex would be at this point here. And again, we know it opens to the right, so we'll make a rough sketch, something like this, to help us find the other major components. This rough sketch is helpful because now we know that the focus, or this point here, must be inside the parabola or to the right of the vertex. And the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a, which is also the distance from the vertex to the directrix. So because a is equal to positive 2, and the absolute value of positive 2 is still positive 2, the focus must be 2 units to the right of the vertex. So this would be the focus here. And by looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the coordinates of the focus would be 1, 2. Notice how we could have found this x-coordinate by adding a to the x-coordinate of the vertex if we wanted to. Then the directrix must be 2 units to the left of the vertex because the parabola opens to the right. So the directrix would pass through this point here. It would be a vertical line that looks like this. Again, just by looking at the coordinate plane, we know the equation of the directrix would be x equals negative 3. We could have also found this equation by subtracting 2 from the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice negative 1 minus 2. And now for the axis, or axis of symmetry, that's the line for which the parabola is symmetrical across. We can also think of it as a line that cuts the parabola in half, which would be this line here, passing through both the vertex and the focus. So for our sketch, the axis of symmetry would be this horizontal line. And again, by looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the equation of this horizontal line will be y equals 2. Notice how it's also the same value as the y coordinate of the vertex. And now we'll find the endpoint of the lattice rectum, sometimes called the focal diameter. Again, going back to our notes, this green segment here is the lattice rectum. It's parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus, and has both endpoints on the parabola. The length of the lattice rectum is equal to the absolute value of 4a. So notice that in our equation, 4a is equal to 8. So the length of the lattice rectum is 8 units. So to find the endpoint of the lattice rectum, since the focus is the midpoint, if we go up 4 units, this would be one endpoint of the lattice rectum. If we go down 4 units from the focus, we'd have the other endpoint of the lattice rectum. So looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the coordinates of this point here would be 1, 6. And the coordinates of the second point would be 1, negative 2. We could have also found these endpoints by adding and subtracting 4 from the y-coordinate of the focus. Notice 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, and 2 minus 4 is equal to negative 2. So now that we have the latus rectum, or focal diameter, we can now make a more accurate sketch for our parabola. Using the vertex and the two endpoints that we just found, the parabola would look something like this. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.